Budapest 100 is a simple, cheap, but very efficient tool to enhance a sense of belonging, since everybody is keen on looking behind the closed doors, getting to know little secrets and stories of buildings, especially if it's told by the residents. A very typical feedback of participating residents is that they have never ever thought that their building and stories can be interesting for anyone else.
That is why we use the method of Budapest 100 in a new setup in Őrmező, namely in a symbolic prefabricated housing estate of Budapest, and that is why we recommend this method to other cities as well.
Let's see how it works and why is it so important. Doing volunteering for your own neighborhood strengthens the sense of belonging very much. Budapest 100 activates residents on a super local level through celebration of residential buildings, but these are buildings not necessarily with outstanding or stunning architectural values.
And also for collecting and sharing stories, and what's more, doing a small piece of community action, since communities are formed when we do something together. Celebrating and using the method of Budapest 100 is an ideal first step to activate communities.
Our advice would be to pick up a suitable neighborhood, then find out what to celebrate exactly. Celebration creates an opportunity to bond together and establish deep trust. Celebration and connection is key. We say that Budapest 100 can be implemented basically anywhere in any neighborhood where building on local identity is still possible, because every building is interesting, says the motto of the Budapest 100. In our case, in Őrmező, it was not an easy choice, especially since the good practice has been tested in historic buildings before.
Find some characteristic storytellers among the residents, articulate what is unique about the neighborhood, and build on their local knowledge. In Őrmező, we built on the fact that people here still say hello to each other like in a village, and this is quite special and important, as it's definitely not the case in Budapest.
In order to properly engage the residents, build your activities on collective ownership of local initiatives and let people get inspired. In our case, it was the local community garden and a popular Facebook group.
So we started there. But we also built on local NGOs and other connectors in the community, like the community house, the youth center, and a very agile local committee member. Yet during the first festival, we coped with many barriers and failures, as we realized that community building takes time.
Co-create community and placemaking actions to increase community spirit and thus sense of belonging. Organize co-creation activities with the residents or create a display where they can express their thoughts.
The main goal of the good practice is not to protect buildings, but to activate communities through heritage and initiate discussions on urban revival on the local level. That is why we established a community installation in the middle of the neighborhood, where locals could go down on their collective memory lane by personal photos and parallelly express their wishes for a better neighborhood.
During Budapest 100, we do not only celebrate, but try to involve residents to share their thoughts and opinions regarding the future of their neighborhood. But also the celebration provides a supportive environment where residents feel themselves encouraged.
We believe that enhancing a sense of belonging efficiently motivates people to care about their built environment and their local community. It increases the so-called social capital, or community spirit, or neighborliness. Enhancing a sense of belonging and thus neighborliness has profound effect on the individual, like including better mental and physical health, but also related to the community, including informal social control, and it can facilitate mutual aid and support between people.
The method is efficient as people care and value public spaces better when they have knowledge, emotional connection, and responsibility connected to these places. Ownership of public places creates responsible citizens. Responsible citizens take care of their environment, and of course, taking care of our environment transforms cities. That was our mantra, and thanks to Urbact, we tried it, and the first steps were successful. We worked with cities like Varaždin, Plasencia, Targovec, or Pori. We were trying to prove for the residents that their buildings are valuable, and as the motto says, that every building is interesting.